Both of us, if not today. Well. Never tell a lie, Tanagan.
For what you
Starbucks again.
Yes, 6 weeks is a long time.
Yes, it is.
Now, would you all come here for a moment, please?
Everyone, quickly, quickly, everyone.
Everyone, this is Annie. She'll be with us for the next 2 weeks.
Miss.
Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your dog, Miss?
Will I get him back?
Of course, dear.
Gee, I really love my dog, Miss Farrah.
I know, dear. Now, Annie, what would you like to do first?
The floors, then the windows.
So, Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning while you're here.
I won't?
Of course not. You're our guest. And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time. Now.
Annie, what?
Well, we
fire.
Well, it's your first time here, sir.
It is. Well, anyway, I've just been informed that it's your first night here. I suppose we'll have to do something special for you then, huh? Let's see. I know. How would you like to go to the movies?
I would love to. I would really love to. I mean, I've read a lot of them, but I've never been to one before.
Never?
Thank you. Pardon me, Blondie.
Hiya, sis. How you doing?
Rooster? Home. Oh, it never rains, but it pours. So they finally let me out of Leavenworth?
I got 6 months off for good behavior.
I bet. What was it for this time?
Some old geezer from Yonkers said I swindled him out of $1,100.
Oh, yeah? Let me see.
$5
$5? I'm gonna laugh. You and your big
wife would like to come over that same day for dinner. Oh, you would? Good. I'll see you then, Mr. President. Goodbye. If I knew he was going to say yes, I would never have asked him. Grace, call Al Smith and find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
And make a note. Meeting in the White House, 11 a.m. with President Roosevelt.
Yes, sir.
Now, has the package arrived at Tiffany's yet?
Yes, sir. It arrived this morning.
Good. I'm going to give this to her and tell her I want to adopt her. Where is Annie?
Well, she's upstairs, sir, writing down a letter to her friends in the orphanage. I'll have Drake call her.
Fine. Oh, damn.
You don't have to be nervous, sir. She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Damn right she is. Get her down here.
Yes, sir. Drake, Mr. Wilmot will see Annie now.
Miss Annie! Mr. Wilmot will see her now.
Thank you, Mr. Drake. Hello.
Hello, Annie. How are you today?
Fine, sir. How are you?
I'm fine. Annie, can we have a very serious conversation?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
No, of course not. Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
Sure.
Good. Annie, I grew up in the streets of New York, in a place they call Hell's Kitchen. Both my parents died before I was 10. When I was very young, I thought to myself, someday, one way or another, I was going to be rich, very rich.
That was a good idea.
I know. Anyhow, by the time I was 23, I made my first million. In 10 years, I turned that into 100 million. And in those days, Annie, that was a lot of money. Anyhow, I might as well tell you, I was ruthless to those I had to climb over to get to the top. Because I always believed in one thing. You don't have to be nice to people on the way up if you don't plan on coming back down again. But lately I've realized something. No matter how many room rent seducing groups you've got, if you're alone, if you have no one to share your life with, then you may as well be broke and back in Hell's Kitchen. Do you understand what I'm trying to say, Annie?
Sure.
Good.
Kind of. And guess what?
Damn. Annie, I was at Tiffany's the other day, and I picked this up for you. I had it in gray.
For me, Mr. Wilmot, thank you. You're so nice to me.
It's a new locket. I noticed the old broken one you always wore, and I thought to myself, I'm going to get that girl a new locket.
Thank you, Mr. Warbucks. Thank you very much.
Here, maybe just put it on for you.
No, please. I don't want a new locket.
Well, take him off the Dillinger case. Annie, give me the locket. I know, but I'll give the locket to the FBI, and they'll be able to trace where it was manufactured, and then find out who bought it.
Maybe they should have my note, too.
Yes. Thank you, Annie. You just wait. You may be meeting your parents within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
I gotta write a letter to tell the kids about this.
Okay.
Rowdy two fights, bad rap. Thank you, Mohini, and good night. Did I just do a commercial?
So, Annie's parents, if you're listening, you got $50,000 waiting for you to wind your little daughter.
So get in touch right away, you hear?
Well, I look on the clock on the wall, that is one of our Thursday night get-togethers comes to a close faster than you can say oxygen.
Thank you.
Excuse me, miss, but are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah.
Oh, Ralph, I'm scared. Something could have happened to her.
Don't worry, Shirley. It's going to be okay, Shirley. She's going to be here, and she's going to be ours again. Ma'am, was you working here about 11 years ago?
Yeah.
Well, we was having terrible troubles back then, and we had to move north to Canada, and we had to leave a baby here on the front stoop. Yes, ma'am, we are.
Annie's parents? I can't believe this. Where did you say you were from?
Well, we come from a little farm up in Canada where there's lots of chickens and ducks and geese and roosters!
She so wanted to meet you that I couldn't resist.
bring her along, just to say hello.
Annie, of course, the little girl who sang so beautifully on the radio last night.
How do you do, President Roosevelt?
And how do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sound on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, shall we begin?
Annie, get those step outside for me.
No, no, let Annie stay. Having a child on hand will keep us in our best behavior.
Thank you, Mr. President.
And Ike's. I don't want to hear as much as a gosh out of you. Now, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans who have any money left, I'd like to begin with your view on matters.
Thank you, Mr. President. In the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country is business. And for the good of the people, the country, Wall Street, and me, you've got to get my factories open and the workers back to work.
Mr. President, according to my latest figures, and nearly 50 million Americans with no visible means of support.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem right now. The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be a war.
Germany, how? People are starving in this country.
Yikes, I know that, but in the long run...
Cordell, for those people who are starving, there is no long run. The trouble is, it's all happening at once. The stock market has taken another nosedive.
Sit-down strikes, floods, riots, dust storms,
and the FBI still hasn't caught Dillinger.
Well, at least we'll all agree to one thing. The situation is hopeless and getting much worse.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet you $5 tomorrow.
President. Good day.
Goodbye, Patty.
Goodbye, Patty.
Goodbye, President Roosevelt. And thank you.
Oh, thank you, Abby. You're the type of person the President should have around him all the time.
Mr. President, what if we set up 100 or 1,000 federal projects?
Stamps.
Highways.
Post offices.
And put the unemployed to work building them.
We can create 5 million new jobs in 6 months.
And weekly paychecks will get those millions of relief and back to paying taxes.
We'll build a country so strong, including Chancellor, that it couldn't beat us in a war.
The FBI caught Baby Face Nelson, didn't they? They're bound to catch Dillinger.
Mr. President, what we have to give this country is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new approach.
A new concept.
A new dedication.
A new horizon.
A new spirit.
A new attitude.
A new deal. Gentlemen, I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
My speeches are great.
someone, but who?
this year is the wife, Shirley.
You never knew it, dear. But you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
We was sick and broke, and we had no place to turn. And a man up in Canada gave us a chance to work on his farm.
But we couldn't bring along no baby.
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
Mr. Mudge, is it? We've seen a great number of people.
Proof. I especially wanted proof of who we are. Here's our driver's licenses and Annie's birth certificate.
A baby girl named Anne Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th. That's my birthday.
It was in her notes, sir.
Yes, I know, but still.
Mister, please, you gotta believe us. We got on the Greyhound this afternoon, and we went straight to the orphanage. And the lady there said, we had to come here.
Oh, Annie, all the years I dreamed of holding you in my arms again.
Mr. Mudge, on the night when Annie was...
Oh, here's something that you wouldn't know about. But when we left Annie at the orphanage, we left her with half of a silver locket, and we kept the other half so that...
Well, look, Annie's wearing it.
And here's the part we kept. It fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph. She's our Annie.
She seems to be.
She is. She is. So, if you'll be getting her things together, we'll be taking her along.
Take her?
No.
Wait a minute, Mr. Mudge. What about the money?
Money? Well, we ain't got much, but we...
You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's parents.
No, sir. We ain't heard nothing about no check. Besides, we don't want no money.
Right. We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that little pig farm up in New Jersey? With $50,000, we could afford to buy it and bring Annie upright. With fresh air, fresh eggs.
Fresh ham!
Fresh ham. Certified. All I gotta do is make it up to myself?
That's right. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Yes. If Annie could stay here for tonight, and then you can come back tomorrow and pick up her and a check.
Oh.
Oh. Well, whatever you prefer, sir. Well, me and Cheryl will be getting back to our hotel now. Bye, Annie.
Bye, Annie, love.
Until tomorrow, honey. Then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us. Pardon me, Annie.
Well, this is wonderful news.
Yes, sir.
Annie has found her parents, and they seem to be a very nice couple.
Yes, finish
it. You're lucky, Annie.
Right. I'm lucky. Just say. New Jersey.
Drink.
Yes, sir.
Champagne.
Yes, sir.
Annie, it's the most wonderful day, and we've had the most wonderful news. You found your parents. And so, I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie.
Annie.
Hello, everybody.
Annie.
I seem to have the same effect on everyone today, Oliver.
I've lost her, Franklin. I've lost Annie.
Sir, that Mr. Mudge. I think I've seen him someplace before. I just can't remember where or when, but I have the strangest feeling he's not when he says this.
Franklin, I need your help.
Of course, Oliver. Whatever I can do for you.
Thank you. Yes. I'll see you, Amy.
You're early, too.
We've been up all night,
dear.
And had quite a time. FBI man coming, going. Annie, did you know that President Roosevelt was here?
Really?
Annie, I have something very difficult to tell you. And President Roosevelt is going to help me do it. Franklin.
Annie, earlier this morning, FBI Director Hoover came to me with some very sad news. Through the handwriting on your paper, he was able to trace the identity of your parents.
Yes, we already know that. Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, dear. Your parents aren't Mr. and Mrs. Mudge. They're David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Where are they?
Oh, Annie.
Annie, your parents passed away a long time ago.
You mean they're dead?
Yes, dear.
So I'm an orphan after all, like the other kids.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes. You see, I guess I kind of knew it all along, because I knew they loved me. They would have come back for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
I love you too. Now who the heck is Ralph and Shirley Blunt?
That girl! Who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
That birth certificate could easily have been forged, but the thing is, they knew about the locket.
The locket? That's your key.
But nobody knew about the locket, except us, and the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And
Miss Hannigan. Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Ah, good. Send her in.
Yes, sir. Right this way, Dad.
Miss Hannigan, how wonderful it is to see you.
Same here, and I've known you anyways. You're the Oliver Woodbox, right?
Yeah, yes. perhaps I should introduce you. This is my secretary, Grace Farrell. You know her. And that's the President of the United States. And that's my butler, Drake.
Hey.
Hi, kid.
Hi, Annie.
Gee, what a great place.
Who's going to live in this room?
Hey, there's presents here for all of you.
Oh, my goodness.
Mr. Wilbox, another telegram from the FBI.
Ah, Betty Drake. Comes the dawn. Now it all fits together.
Annie, come look at this.
Leaping lizards? Who would have guessed?
Mr. Wallace, Mr. Ralph and Shirley Mudge are here.
Send them in, Drake.
With pleasure, sir. Right this way, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Good morning, everyone. Well, we don't want to be keeping you for very long, so we're just here to pick up Annie, her luggage, and oh yes, the check.
Ah, yes, of course, the check. Here it is, Mr. Mudge, $50,000 certified.
Certified, paid in the order of Ralph Mudge.
Read it again.
Good. Certified. Read. Paid in the order of... The jig is up.
That's right. The jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Mr. Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge.
Also known as Danny the Dick.
Mr. President, I believe that fraud is a federal offense and that your secret servicemen have the power to arrest.
Yes, Oliver, they certainly do. Louise, turn that over.
Yes, sir.
And I believe you'll find that Miss Hannigan is their accomplice.
Me? I never seen these people till yesterday.
Oh, come on, Miss Eggie.
Yeah, me and Lola's taking a fall, and so are you.
Mr. Corpus.
Oliver, I ain't never done anything to you.
The jig is up, man.
Annie, tell him how nice and good I always was to you.
Gee, I'm Florida Tina.
have to work anymore.
Hooray!
Instead, you'll have teachers and classrooms.
Hooray!
We are together at last and together forever.
Together at last.
Hello? Right. Okay. Just before you all leave, we just have a couple of thank yous that we want to do. Teddy.
Right there. Okay. We'd like to thank the following people for their contributions to Annie. Ms. Randalls, Ms. Alfano, Mr. Waterworth, Ms. Hickman, Mr. Anderson, Ms. Keith Matt, Ms. Shannon, Drama and Tech Classes, Mr. Merritt, Ms. Tess, and all the other parents and parents.
Expected to become my second mother. And as I'm sure she has been to many of the students For all of us, he's done it for three of us. Everyone else? It's been a pleasure meeting with you and working with you.
Thank you very much, and good night.